The Roaring Fork Transportation Authority, or RAFTA, provides mass transit to several areas of Colorado, including Aspen, Glenwood Springs, Snowmass, Pitkin and Eagle Counties, Basalt, and others. RAFTA secured funding to begin a bus rapid transit system to provide faster, reliable, convenient mass transit to its customers. And as a part of this plan, they decided to choose natural gas instead of diesel. This project is the first rural bus rapid transit system in the country. It includes 22 new CNG buses, 3 CNG fueling stations, one that is indoor, received the White House Champions of Change Transportation Innovators Award, and plans to convert all 92 buses are in the making. This project is significant and progressive for many reasons. The first being that RAFTA operates at a very high altitude, often over 8,000 feet, and serves a very rural community. The functionality of CNG buses was scrutinized because the nature of their routes required large amounts of torque and power, even at high elevation. After much testing and research, the CNG buses outperformed its competition with acceleration and fuel economy. And after calculating the fuel cost savings that result from cheap natural gas, the choice was simple. Many things were special about this project, and Mike Golden of MW Golden Constructors, who designed the fueling facility, took a moment to explain.
Our construction firm did the CNG fueling station here,
okay,
which is takes the fuel from a 4-inch gas line that comes from down in the street, brings it into the compressors, put it into storage spheres inside. Then those gas lines run over to the Glenwood maintenance facility, and we have an outdoor fueling station right there where those three gentlemen are standing. And then we have indoor fueling inside the fuel bay. So at this particular facility, RAFTA can fuel diesel inside and compressed natural gas, which is abnormal in the country to have indoor fueling of CNG. In order to do that, we had to harden the fuel bay so it could take a deflagration in case something would go wrong. And on the north side of this fuel bay are deflagration vents that, in case of a deflagration, the vents would pop open, let the pressure out of the building so that the building stands. All of the mechanical systems within the Glenwood maintenance facilities were upgraded for CNG, so that if you get a CNG leak from working on the buses, the systems will pull the gas out, open the overhead doors, shut down non-essential electrical systems, and we also upgraded the electrical within 18 inches of the ceiling.
The project is incredibly significant to the state of Colorado, so much so that Governor Hickenlooper made an appearance at the grand opening. Here are his remarks.
Natural gas in just a second, but having the BRT, the Bus Rapid Transit, up here, I had a meal with Secretary Ray LaHood, who's going to step down as the Secretary of Transportation in the Obama administration, and he was talking about this project, right? Nothing makes the governor more proud than to have the Secretary of Transportation say, you know, do you know these guys are after? You know, kind of Pitkin County, Eagle County, Garfield County. And, oh, yeah, I know those guys. They're doing something no one else has done. The compressed natural gas and this fueling station, again, there's been a revolution, all this horizontal drilling, and you know, we will get the regulations right. We will continue raising regulations to make sure that there's not fugitive methane escaping, or that there's not spills of diesel oil or frac fluid or anything into our waters. We'll get this right, but having inexpensive natural gas that is abundant and creates jobs here, is cleaner, and is significantly less expensive than gasoline, that's not a bad thing. And when you look at the potential, I saw a map last week of the tight shales in China. And if you're worried about climate change, I'm not saying you have to be, but it's real. I mean, climate change is happening. We can fight about the rate is changing, or, you know, we can argue about how much of mankind's efforts are the cause, but it's happening, right? There's no more debate about that. And you can say, well, we can't change it then. That's the other argument you hear. Oh, you can change anything, right? If you look at the potential for natural gas to displace coal-burning electrical generation in China and do what it's done in this country, that is, in real time, the single most hopeful development that we've seen in the last couple decades. In this country, and people don't talk about it a lot, but not just in Colorado, but across the country, natural gas, because it is extensive, so we know that the price isn't going to be spiking all over the place, but it is replacing coal and electrical generation all across the country to the point where we have reduced carbon emissions on a per capita basis in the United States to the same level they were in 1960. Right? So back when Eisenhower turned over the White House to Kennedy, that we have also, even though we never signed the Kyoto Protocol, the U.S. is halfway towards compliance with Kyoto. And we have reduced our carbon emissions more than all the other countries that did sign on to Kyoto, more than all of them combined. Right? Again, in no way does it diminish the responsibility we all have to continue investing with subsidies and research into wind, into solar. I mean, natural gas is going to be a transition, right, over the next 10 or 15 years. But we can't take our eye off the ball that we have to continue making those investments. In the meantime, what you're doing here is a great model. I mean, again, cleaner, less expensive, jobs here. We'll make sure we have the regulatory environment to make sure we protect the air and the water. It's almost, in those ways, it's an opportunity that really brings so many multiple benefits to it. And, you know, I ask some of the smaller school districts all over the state, we should figure out how to do a refueling station like this in centralized locations so that school districts can harvest some of that that lower cost and cleaner environmental consequences that natural gas brings. Again, what you're doing here becomes a model and allows me, when I go around the rest of the state, to talk about what Raft is doing.